Sometimes when we do these videos, there's a bit of a tension. You see, through these recipes, we want to help transport you to a place that maybe you've never been. After all, you might not be able to afford a plane ticket to Chengdu, but you've probably got some sort of Asian supermarket local to you. We always want to help recreate these flavors at home in your kitchen. But sometimes in the process, the true essence of a dish can actually get a little lost in the translation. Like in South Sichuan, Douhuafan or chili tofu rice is practically a lifestyle. Little Douhua joints dot these cities, and come lunchtime you can see all manner of people piling into these restaurants and enjoying some delicious tofu rice. But the key word there is restaurants. This sort of Douhua-style tofu is delicious, but making it at home is definitely a process, and the kicker is that it doesn't keep. Also, doesn't freeze. So while we've covered true blue straight from Sichuan chili tofu rice on this channel before, that recipe is probably better served for events and potlucks than it would be for random weekday lunches, which is, of course, the true essence of chili tofu rice. So today, while we definitely aren't going to be throwing authenticity out the window, it might just be chilling a little bit on the sill. Because what we're aiming to accomplish here is whipping up well a couple things that can keep in advance, and doing the simplest of possible cooking the lunch of, so that you can enjoy some delicious chili tofu rice from your work-from-home desk or maybe even your workplace, depending on your office. So then, okay, here's what we were thinking about logistically. To do this, you're going to need an electric kettle, or at least some way to get some hot boiled water. 20 minutes before lunch, take out your tofu, a block of soft tofu, ideally, but you could also use medium. I just wouldn't really recommend firm, because it won't really combine too well with the rice. Then just toss a teaspoon of salt into your container a bit on the side, and dissolve it with the hot water from the kettle. This salt water soak will help remove that grassy taste from the tofu. Then, if you've got a work-from-home sort of setup with a rice cooker handy, now would be a nice time to whip up some rice. But nuked leftovers would also be as good of a route as any. So then, after those 20 minutes, the tofu should be basically room temperature-ish. So then drain out the water, and to your container optionally toss in a bed's worth of bean sprouts if you're in the mood. Nestle the tofu on, fill it all up with some more hot boiled water once again, and then this is ready to get devoured with your chili-laced dipping sauces, which are, of course, the true star of the dish. Now, our idea was that because these guys were a good bit more intense, you could prep, store, and fridge the dips in advance, maybe the weekend before. Then, to complete the meal, because things are a little light on veg as they stand, we'll also prep a mise-relevant Sichuan-style cold vegetable at the same time, and store it in the form of like a mason jar salad. And then with those elements in place, I think that this is a pretty excellent option for a lunch. Cheap, complete, nutritious, super delicious, and all ready in like no time flat. So then, today we prep three different dip and vegetable combinations for you to choose from. First is a toasted chili oil dipping sauce together with a bit of cold celery on the side. Second, a chili bean paste dipping sauce together with a bit of lotus root. And finally, a chili and black bean dip, which we sorted together with some broccoli. So, starting with the toasted chili one, you'll predictably need some chilies. These were 50 grams of dried Argentiao chilies, but do use the chili peppers that are convenient for you. Guajillos would be nice, ditto with arbols and Kashmiris, but feel free to use generic nondescripts if that's all you got. Then over a low flame, toast the chilies for about 7 minutes or so till they deepen in color and become a bit brittle. The exact timing will depend on how fresh your dried chilies are, but by the end they should be able to easily break when you rub them between your fingers. Then remove, toss on a wire strainer or colander, and shake out some of those excess seeds. At this point, we'll transfer those over to a mortar and pound them into a coarse powder. If you don't own a mortar, no problem. You can also do the exact same thing with a food processor or even just pulse it in a blender. Just make sure that you're looking at something that looks much like this in the end, and set that aside. Next, toss 150 grams or 3/4 cup of oil to a pot. This will form the base flavor, so you do want it to be tasty. We used Sichuan saizio, but either Indian mustard seed oil or peanut would also work great. Over a high flame, bring that up till it's smoking, about 220 centigrade, then shut off the heat. Let that cool down a bit, and over a medium-low flame, toss in an inch of smashed ginger, together with a quarter of an onion cut into slices. Let those fry until the onion gets good and golden brown, about 10 minutes. Then toss in a half a cinnamon stick, 1-star anise, and a quarter teaspoon of fennel seed. After another minute or so of frying, strain everything out, then return the oil to your pot. Heat that up till the oil can bubble around a pair of chopsticks, or about 150 centigrade. Then add in the toasted chili flakes, mix well, and shut off the heat. Now, this oil is good to go, but a quick word on substitution. If you don't feel like walking this whole mile of making your own toasted chili oil, no problem. For this recipe, you can also swap this guy completely for some Laogama chili crisp, which is also one type of toasted chili oil. It's got a little more chili in it, a bit less oil, it's a little less complex, but for this recipe, feel free to swap it in one for one. Now, to make your final dipping sauce then, mix together 1 tablespoon of your toasted chili oil or Laogama chili crisp, 1 tablespoon of soy sauce, 1/8 teaspoon salt, 1/4 teaspoon MSG, 1/4 teaspoon Sichuan peppercorn powder, about 1 tablespoon of chopped cilantro, and 1/4 teaspoon of toasted sesame seeds. Mix well, and this dip is good to go. Now, for our vegetable then, we went with celery here, but really, do feel free to use any vegetable that you want. Either way, peel your celery to give it a better texture. Chop those ribs in half, then cut each into 1.5-inch sections. Then give that a quick blanch in boiling water for about 1/2 minute. Remove, rinse under running water to stop the cooking process, and set that aside. So then, to season that, in your mason jar, just toss in 1 tablespoon of your toasted chili oil or Laogama chili crisp, 1/2 tablespoon of soy sauce, 1/2 teaspoon of dark Chinese vinegar, 1/8 teaspoon salt, 1/2 teaspoon sugar, 1/8 teaspoon MSG, and a drizzle of toasted sesame oil. Nestle 200 grams worth of your cooked celery on top of that, and shake it all up when you're ready to eat it. Now, for our second dip-veg combination, we're going to be doing something based off of a dip called yosu douban, or crispy chili bean paste, which also goes quite nice together with some lotus root. But because we'll obviously need some chili bean paste to make our crispy chili bean paste, a quick word on sourcing before we get into it. See, what you're going to be looking for here is a bottle of chili bean paste much like this one, a red oil chili bean paste. While this is basically the default chili bean paste if you are shopping around in China, in the West you often see packages of chili bean paste sans red oil. These packs are actually a better, more premium product, but they can also be a bit finicky to work with. So for this one, what we're calling for is the red oil chili bean paste, which is also quite available online just in case it's not at your local Chinese supermarket. Either way, just scoop out 6 tablespoons of your chili bean paste and give that a good mince. After all, you don't want some big salty beans floating around your tofu dip. Now, to a wok or pot or whatever, toss in 3/4 cup of oil and just like before, bring that up to smoke point, then cool it down. Then, over a medium-low flame, start to fry 1 inch of smashed ginger, 2 sprigs of cilantro, 2 stalks of celery, 1/4 onion, and the white section of 2 scallions. Fry those for about 10 minutes, or until the onions are getting good and golden, then toss in the same spice mix from before, optional but preferred, just like before. Fry for another minute, strain, then return the oil to the pot. Next, over a medium-low flame, add in your minced chili bean paste to the oil and let that fry. You're aiming to really stain that oil and crisp up the bean paste inside, so do be patient. This process will take about 15 minutes. You'll know it's done once the minced beans have dried up and began to sort of feel a bit like loose sand if you pulled a pair of chopsticks through it. So then just remove and set that aside. Now, to make this dip, just mix together 1.5 tablespoons of your chili bean paste oil mixture, 1 tablespoon of soy sauce, 1/4 teaspoon sugar, 1/8 teaspoon MSG, 1 large clove's worth of minced garlic, 1/2 tablespoon or so of chopped scallion, and 6 peanuts toasted and crushed. And really, definitely do feel free to use like supermarket roasted snack peanuts here. It's really not enough peanut to make too much of a difference. So then with that sorted, let's prep some lotus root. Now, we're gonna be going for sticks today. So first slice your root into 1-centimeter sheets, then stack those up and slice into 1-centimeter sticks. And, quick word, that lotus root loves to break irregularly, so don't freak out if your cuts aren't perfect. Then just bring a pot of water up to a boil and toss in a tablespoon of vinegar at first. The acid will help prevent the lotus root from oxidizing and turning brown when it's sitting in the fridge waiting to go to work. Just boil the lotus root until it's done, or about 3 minutes, then strain and rinse under cool water. Then, same idea. To your trusty mason jar, toss in a half tablespoon of the chili bean paste oil, a half tablespoon of soy sauce, a half teaspoon of sugar, an eighth teaspoon MSG, an eighth teaspoon of white pepper powder, and a drizzle of toasted sesame oil. Nestle your lotus root on top of that, about 200 grams worth cooked, together with an optional half tablespoon of chopped scallions for the sake of good looking. And just like before, shake it all up when you're ready to eat. Finally, for our last dip vegetable combination, a chili oil with black beans repurposed with a bit of broccoli. Now, for this one, forgive us for running a little low on steam here, so we're taking the easy way out and basing all of this one off of Laogama chili oil with black bean. You see, for the unaware, while the chili crisp is probably the most popular Laogama product abroad, the black bean version is actually the OG Laogama. It's an absolute classic flavor from the Guizhou province, and it's a combination that goes absurdly great with tofu. So then, our dipping sauce here is going to be loosely Guizhou inspired. 1 tablespoon of Laogama black bean chili, 1 teaspoon of soy sauce, 1/2 teaspoon of Sichuan peppercorn powder, 1/4 teaspoon salt, 1/8 teaspoon MSG, 1/2 tablespoon of scallion, and 1/2 tablespoon of Guizhou deep roasted chili flakes. So yeah, if you're in the market, we do have a recipe for Guizhou style chili flakes inside of our homemade Laogama video from a few years back. And while we could whip some up today, again, we're starting to kind of run out of steam. So while it's not too bad to make it yourself, it's just toasting and pounding after all. If you can get your hands on some Thai toasted chili powder, prick bun is basically the same thing. But if that's inconvenient too, we found that using a mix of 1 teaspoon of chili flakes together with 1/2 teaspoon of smoked paprika ended up hitting basically the same notes for this recipe. So we'll just mix that up, toss that in, and then this dip is also good to go. Then lastly, the vegetable, same deal as before. Give it a blanch for about 1 minute for broccoli, then strain and shock under cool water. The sauce then for this one is really quite simple, so I'll just list it all up on the screen here. It's basically the same as the dip minus the flakes and scallions. So then just set that aside and mix it when you're ready to eat.
So before we show you how to eat this, just one quick note about the dipping sauces. So these 3 dipping sauces are 3 kind of more general dipping sauces, 2 from Sichuan, 1 Guizhou inspired. The most famous Douhua places in Sichuan is Fushun, which Wang Gang is from, and he actually made a video a couple years back showing you how to make the whole thing. And also another town next to it, Luzhou, also got great Douhua style, and we make a video covering the Luzhou style Douhua a couple years back. So now let's show you how to eat it. So basically, you just stir your sauce really well, make sure it's all mixed, and get a small piece of your tofu and dip in your chili oil of choice and eat it with some of your hot rice. So right, check out the recipe in the description box. A big thank you for everyone that's supporting us on Patreon. And of course, don't forget to subscribe for more Chinese cooking videos.